So we're back up north today. It's just me and Grandpa, the hired man. We didn't bring him in today because the elevator is closed. They said, because my uncle, he is the manager over there, he said we didn't have enough trucks coming yesterday to justify being open today. I understand that, but it's kind of inconvenient for us and a few other people. But we're going to show what we can. We got two trailers in the grain cart, and Uncle Dennis, he's going to bring up one of his semis. He's done, so he's going to bring it up. We're going to fill it. We're just hoping we'll be able to fill, use three trailers and get this done. We don't know. If not, oh well. We're doing what we can. It means the elevator's closed. They first kind of pulled the bungees on us, but it'd be fine. They, at least they can justify it. Bungees never could. But anyway, enough complaining about elevators, even though bungees suck. But anyway, on to showing corn. Had a little corn left in this car from last night. Didn't think it was that much, but I guess he had a little more in supper than I figured. So I'm gonna have to take this to the trailer now. This corn ain't doing so hot. It's replant corn and it didn't do worth a dang here, so he'll be able to make the rest of the field. Other truck's full, bringing the super tent up here, gonna shell it. It should be able to hold a good chunk of that, if not all of it, depends on how it does. If it's been like the rest of it, it'll hold it. The other truck and trailer should be here in about half an hour or so. Got me another hopper full. This corn's doing a little better than the rest of it has been, but still ain't the best. But this truck's about full. Uncle Des just texted me a few minutes ago and said I'll be there pretty soon. So, time I get another hopper, I'll put part of it on this and then take that this truck down on the hill and get the other one. Grandpa took back over running the combine. I had unloaded the cart and he said, I'm going to jump the combine and got to keep things rolling for him. Get the trailer full. That's my uncle's truck and trailer. It's an old Cornhusker grain trailer. The hoppers on it are weird. They're different compared to our Chandler Wilson. It's got an international semi on it. Man, that corn didn't amount to nothing up here. I hope the 80's a lot better. That'd be another hopper. another hopper. You probably won't get another full hopper tonight no more than there is. I know better than doing so. With a little bit I got on here, I'm going to finish filling this trailer. Then if I have a little bit left, I'm going to wait, and whatever he gets off, whatever corn's left, I'll use it and top off the Wilson trailer. It could use a little more, but we're probably going to have to keep some in this grain cart because we ain't got enough trailers. Well, the truck and trailer ahead of us, I got it full. Went and topped off the Wilson. It's full. Topped off the Jet. It's completely full, and I still got a little bit in the cart, so it'll just stay in there. We got a tarp on this thing in case we want to cover it, which may not even worry about it. I don't think it's really something to worry about. Grandpa says, don't worry about tarping them. There ain't no point in it. There's the old International we're using. I got this trailer loaded down to see if we can even get it out of here or not. It's gotten progressively sticky over the past few days in this field, so we'll see what happens. It'll probably spin a little bit, I imagine. The other ones did. I'd say these Internationals are definitely different than a freight shaker. Clutch on them is pretty stiff once you get past about halfway on them. Trailer brakes don't like to release on this thing either. If that may be the brakes on the trailer doing that, I don't know. Last pass on this field. Finally over. Now we can move to the 80.